Hello student, myself Professor Gada Kisses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Student, we are learning the final year subject that is nothing but solar and wind energy. So up to the last lecture, we have seen so many points from unit number 1 to unit number 5. Basically, unit number 1 to unit number 4 are related to the solar energy and unit number 5 is related to the wind energy. Now, in the last lecture also, we have seen some points related to the biomass also. So, related to the biomass, in the last lecture, we have seen the biogas plant structure. That means how that biogas plant will work and which are the components of that biogas plants along with its diagram. We have understand that how biogas plant will work. So, basically, we have understand that the animal dung is mixed with the water to make the slurry. That slurry will send it to the digester tank where number of chemical reaction will done on the mixed slurry, and from that the biogas will be taken from that slurry, and that slurry from which the biogas is removed, that slurry is used as a nutrient or fertilizer for the farm. So that is the basic working of the biogas power plant we have seen. Now here in the today's lecture, we are going to see one of the case study related to the biogas plant. So how to design that biogas plant, that we are going to see in the today's lecture. So let's see biogas system design for the cooking for a family of 6 members is considered here. That means for how much people's cooking is considered here. For our case study, 6 people's cooking, 6 people family cooking is considered for our biogas plant. The system design includes the estimation of total gas required. What we have to find out? The total gas required, amount of feedstock, that is the dung required, and the number of animals required to have the feedstock of the given amount. That means in the case study, today's case study, what we have to assume? We have to assume that we have to generate the gas to cook the food of the 6 persons family. And here we have to find out, or we have to estimate that amount of total gas required to cook the food for the 6 persons family. Then second thing, how much dung, that is how much animal dung is required. And third thing, we have to estimate how much animals are required to get the particular amount of the animal dung. So let's see step by step. Following assumptions are made for the design. So about 350 to 450 liter of biogas required per day per person for cooking. That means for per day per person, we required 350 to 450 liters of the biogas. In an engine, about 450 liters HPH or per hour of the biogas is required. Now, second thing we have to assume, that is nothing but average production of dung per animal per day. So, average production of dung per animal per day is nothing but for cow, 10 kg per day. It will give the 10 kg per day. For bullock, 14 kg per day, and buffalo, 15 kg per day. So other biomass, night soil, sugarcane, baggage, maize straw, etc. can also be used. Then third assumption we have to consider, 1000 liter of gas is equivalent to 1 meter cube of gas, that all of you know. Average gas production from the dung is about 40 liter per kg. That means from 1 kg of the animal dung, we will consider 40 kg of gas will be generated. Okay. Then retention period for the dung slurry is digester is a 50 days. That means you have to keep that slurry for at least 50 days. And that is the retention period for the dung slurry in the digester tank. So that's are some assumptions which we have to consider for designing the particular amount of the system. Okay. So in the total 3 steps, we are going to find out the total power plant system So let's see the step number one, that is a find out amount of gas required per day. So first step, find out amount of gas required per day. We have considered that for one person 40 kg. So number of family members are 6, we have considered. Now considering 400 liters per day per person for cooking, total gas required are 6 into 400. So 2400 liters per day gas required. So gas required per day is nothing but the 2.4 meter cube gas per day. Note, if other uses of biogas are there, like running engines or lamp or other amount should be added here. Now in the step number one, we have calculated total amount of gas required. For per person we have considered 400 liter. Now for 6 person we have considered 2.4 liter meter cube of gas per day. Now step number two, number of animals required to fulfill the daily gas requirement. Now how much animals are required? We have considered that one gas produced from the 1 kg of fresh dung is nothing but the amount of gas produced from a kg of a fresh dung is nothing but the 40 liters per kg. So total amount of dung required is nothing but total gas required divided by gas per kg of the dung. Total gas required we have taken as 2400, and gas required per kg of the dung, that means gas generated from per kg of the dung, is nothing but the 40 liters. So total 60 kg of the dung is required to make the 2400 meter cube of gas or liter gas per day. So thus, in order to have 60 kg of the dung, number of cow required are 6, because one cow will give average 10 kg of the dung. So total cow required are the 6. So three things we have calculated: total number of gas required, then animal required, and we have calculated also. So 10 kg dung per day per cow is approximate. It varies with the breed of the cow. If there are only buffaloes, then we required only 4. Now that is the step number two. Now step number three is related to the design of digester and gas holder. Design of digester and gas holder means we have to design the tank. Now to store the slurry, we have to calculate. In order to make the slurry, water should be added to equal amount of dunk. That means you have to add the water in equal amount. So the total mass of this slurry is equals to dunk plus water. So dunk required is 60 kg. So 60 kg plus water 60 kg. That means total 120 kg slurry is required. So we have to store the 120 kg of this slurry. So volume of the slurry per day, that is nothing but specific gravity of the slurry, is about the 1090 kg per meter cube. So the total mass of the slurry per specific gravity, that is nothing but total mass of the slurry is 120 kg divided by specific gravity of the slurry, that is nothing but the 1090. So the volume of the slurry per day is nothing but 0.11 meter cube. Now retention period for slurry we have considered that 50 days. So the total volume of the digester is nothing but per day volume of the slurry into the retention period. So per day how much slurry volume of the slurry is 0.11 into retention period is 50. So the total volume of the digester tank is nothing but 5.5 meter cube, or it is related, or it is equivalent to the 6 meter cube. As a thumb rule, digester volume should be about 2.75 times the volume of the gas required per day. Do you understand that? So the dimensions of the digester is equals to depth of diameter ratio should be in between 1 and 1.3. Gas holder tank dimensions. So the volume of the gas holder tank should be about 60% of the per day gas volume. All of you understand that? So we have in the three steps. In the first step, what we have calculated, let's see once again. In the first step, we have calculated the total amount of the gas required for cooking of the 6 persons family. Then in the step number 2, we have calculated how much dung is required and for that much dung, how many animals are required. In the step number 3, we have designed the digester tank. That means we have find out the dimensions for the digester tanks. Like that, we can develop the biogas plants in the 3 steps. So one note is there for the biogas plant design. The temperature of the slurry in the tank plays an important role in the amount of gas production. The production yield is maximum between 45 and 55 degrees Celsius. That means the temperature of that slurry will remain or digester tank should be in between 45 to 55 degrees Celsius for effective achieving the biogas from the slurry. So like that, we have studied one case study related to the design of the biogas plant. So I think all of you understand that study. It is a simple one. So in the 3 step, you can calculate or you can design the biogas plant for the required amount of persons cooking. So I think all of you have understand. Today we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, friends.